this video, let us learn what is mutual funds and SIP. So mutual funds is very simple. Any investment above 5,000 is called mutual fund. And systematic investment plan, any investment per month. So here we are speaking of per month. Every month you have to invest 1,000 rupees per month. So this is called SIP. And you can do 5,000 per month, 10,000 per month. So in SIP, have to do it consistently for more than 1 year, 2 years, like you can fix the tenure also. So SIP is very simple. Monthly investment of 1,000 rupees is called SIP, or monthly investment of any X amount consistently have to do it for more than 1 year or 5 years or anything you want, you wish to invest, is called SIP. Whereas in mutual fund, there is no need to invest monthly. So you can invest 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 5,000, anything above 5,000, invest at one go, leave it for 2 years, 3 years. So this is called mutual funds. Very simple. As for my recommendation, go with SIP. Reason is very simple. In SIPs, you are purchasing NAVs. What is NAV? Net asset value. I'll just show what is NAV next. So you are investing every month 1,000 or 5,000 every month. You are purchasing those NAVs every month. Even if market has fallen also, you are purchasing those NAV. Even if market is on the peak also, you are purchasing that NAVs. Over a period of 5 years or 2 years, those NAV value will increase. So you will be in profits. Very simple. So why we should invest in mutual funds is the next question. So answer is very simple. In mutual funds, the returns will be 18-20% returns if it is an equity related mutual fund, and if it is a debt related mutual fund, the returns will be 9-12%, and if it is a balanced fund, it will be like 12-15%. It always depends on the stock market performance. So what is debt funds? Debt funds are the funds where money goes to government bonds and securities, where safety is 100%. So you cannot expect negative returns in debt funds. Whereas in balanced fund, 50% goes to debt and 50% goes to equity. So their returns will be much higher than debt funds. So for all citizens in India, I recommend them to invest in debt funds. Instead of going in keeping in bank RD or FD, debt funds is 100%. Positive returns, 100% safety for your money. Whereas in equity related mutual funds, it can be 18% positive or 1-2% negative or 5% negative. It all depends on the funds. So I'll just show you some mutual funds now. Go to Money Control app. Just open Money Control app. So there you can go to mutual funds. Top ranked mutual funds, there you can see. Just I am seeing large cap, mid cap, diversified equity, thematic infrastructure, ELSS, and balanced fund. So I'll explain what is large cap. Large cap is a fund where they invest in very big companies. Returns will be 18-20% returns. So this year market has fallen so much, in spite of that, and large cap funds are still positive of 18%. So this is the power of large cap. Whereas if you see mid caps, small and mid cap, returns will be very high compared to large cap, 30% returns. And over a period of 3 years, you can see 19%, 32, for a period of 2 years, 34%. That means if you calculate an average of 3 years, 19% is a return. So 19, so 60%, 60% plus, this is a CAGR returns, not simple returns. Compounded annual growth rate, 1 rupee will become 1 rupee 20 paisa after 1 year. That 1 rupee 20 paisa will start working next year, and again 1 rupee are pumping in SIPs. So 2 rupees 20 paisa, for that 20% returns means it will become 2 rupees 44 paisa after end of 2 years. That's the power of SIP. That's the power of compounding. Any investment which is compounding annually, which is an excellent product, you can invest in those products. In that, mutual funds and SIP are most powerful in India. Every month people are investing 10,000 crores. Just imagine that number, 10,000 crores. And people are telling they don't have money, they are very committed, they don't have excess, blah blah blah, they're telling. But just see the number speaks. Indian people are investing 10,000 crores per month in SIPs. Means people are, I mean, educateds are investing in that, and they're getting very good returns in that. That's why people are investing in these products. So I you can see this ELSS. ELSS is a tax saving scheme. So instead of investing in LICs, where you will get 8% returns per annum, which is like useless returns, 8% per annum. In ELSS schemes, equity linked savings scheme, you'll get 19% returns per annum. So you invest in this ELSS scheme, you can get ATC. Under ATC, you get tax benefits. So let me calculate some SIPs for you. SIP calculator have 1000 rupees per month if you do for a period of 20 years, expecting 20% returns. I'm telling expecting returns may be 16% per annum also. If market is not good, you can expect 16% per annum. If market is very good, I'm just assuming for next 20 years, returns will be very good. So putting 20%, if I calculate, so if you are investing 2.4 lakhs, you are getting 31 lakhs almost. Let us say we'll not get 20% returns, we are getting 18% returns next 20 years. You are getting 23 lakhs, which is, I can assure you, because based on